Okay, mga students, this is the last stretch of our discussion in IFRS 2 on share-based payments. Ito na yung choice 3 natin. If you still recall, no? Meron tayong equity settled, meron tayong cash settled, meron tayong pwedeng either. Okay, pwedeng 1 or 2. So, yun po yung share-based transactions with cash alternatives. So, dito ano, yung terms of the arrangement suggest or provides either the entity or the supplier with a choice of whether the entity settles the transaction in cash or other assets or by issuing equity instruments. Okay. Now, please take note of the following items here. Una, the entity shall determine whether it has a present obligation to settle in cash. Okay? Kailan nagkakaroon ng present obligation? If the choice of settlement in equity instrument has no commercial value. And paano po natin nasasabi na wala yung commercial value? Example, the entity has a past practice. Ito, no? Hindi ito actis. Okay. Naglolo ko yung aking ano minsan, keyboard. So, the entity has a past practice or a stated policy of settling in cash or when the entity is legally prohibited from issuing shares according to paragraph 41 of IFRS 2. Or, ano no, another one, if the entity has a present obligation to settle in cash, so kung meron daw present obligation si entity to settle in cash, edi i-apply natin yung cash settled share-based transactions. If the entity naman has no present obligation to settle in cash, we will apply equity settled share-based payment transaction, ano? As in yung share options. If employees are granted the option to choose whether to receive cash or equity instrument, so nagkakaroon tayo ng compound financial instrument, no? If we are the entity, we are issuing a compound financial instrument. And if you remember, no, sa mga discussions natin, halimbawa sa bonds, no, na mayroong compound financial instruments, halimbawa with a detachable share warrants. So, we have to separate, we have to bifurcate using the residual method or residual approach. So, how do we do that? Okay, let's have an illustration here para mas ma-appreciate po natin ito. Una, on January 1, 2021, an entity granted to its, ano yung COO? Chief Operating Officer. Okay? The right, so grant ni entity, ano, yung COO, ng right to what? To choose, pumili, pili ka COO. Pili. 5,000 ordinary shares or makareceive ng cash payment equal to 4,000 shares. Okay? The grant is conditional upon completion of 2 years of service. So, meron tayong service, ano dito, no? Service condition. The entity estimates that the fair value of the share alternative at the date of grant is 60 peso per share. Par value per share is 40 peso. So, paano magiging relevant yung mga amounts? But before that, before we deal with the computation, meron pa tayong additional information here. Ito po yung mga fair values per share at different dates. 65, 68, 72, and 75. Please take note of the dates, ha? And the COO exercised his rights on June 30, 2023. Etong panghuli. And since dito kasi class, no, meron tayong binibigyan natin si COO, no, ng right para pumili. So, we are issuing, if we are the entity, if we are ABC company, kunwari ito si ABC company ito, no. So, binibigyan natin siya ng option, we are issuing a compound financial instrument. Okay? Now, if the counterparty, which in this case is the COO, and let me just add this, no? Dagdag ko lang ito, coming from the Book of Milan. although it was not included in my presentation. If the counterparty daw has the right to choose settlement between cash or other assets or equity instruments, the entity has granted the compound instrument. And this is reflective of this one that I highlighted. The employees here are the counterparty. Okay? Grinant natin sila ng option to, para pumili. So that is a compound instrument na nag-grinant natin sa kanila. Okay. Class, for a compound financial instrument, dahil meron tayong option 3 dito, so ang proforma journal entry natin will be this one. Magde-debit ka ng compensation expense, may debit ka, may credit ka ng liability, which is your share appreciation rights payable, may credit ka ng share premium share options for the equity component. Okay? Siyempre, for the share appreciation rights payable, we are using the fair value at the end of the year, di ba? Samantalang pag share premium, fair value at the date of grant ang ginagamit natin dito. Now, consider this solution as a guide, no? Since compound financial instrument will have to be separated. So, anong gagawin natin? Please take note of this solution. We will get the fair value of the equity alternative. Ano yung equity alternative natin diyan? Ito no, yung option na 5,000 ordinary shares. Pag equity, di ba, at the date of grant, ito yun. Yung fair value is 60. So, 5,000 times 60, we will get 300,000. Kukuha. While the fair value of the debt component is, paano natin i-compute yun? Oh, this is the share appreciation rights payable. Okay? Ang cash payment equal to 4,000 shares. Oh, so, ang basis natin ay 4,000. Mumultiply natin sa 65. At the date of grant ito, no, on January 1, 2021 pa naman. So, compare natin. This is the fair value of the equity alternative. Ito yung fair value ng debt component. O, ibig sabihin, 40,000 dyan ay para doon sa share premium, share options. Okay? Now, tignan po ninyo ito. For the fair value of the liability, on December 31, 2021, gagamitin natin ito na 68. For 2022, gagamitin natin yung 72. For 2023, gagamitin natin itong 75. So, kinumpute na agad natin ito, no? O, ito yung mga relevant information in terms of the fair value of the liability. Okay? Now, class. Parang nabanggit ko kanina, no? At the date of grant. Kanina, no? Parang, nung in-explain ko ito. Okay? Allow me to correct myself, no? Kasi, pag ano, no, on the date of grant, whether equity settled, whether cash settled, or compound, no, we will only issue a memo. Memorandum entry lang tayo at the date of grant. Pero ito, kakailanganin natin ito later on. Okay? Ito, for purposes of computation. Kasi, tandaan po ninyo, in this proforma entry, the share premium, share options will be using, no, fair value at the date of grant. So, etong 40,000, this will be fixed. Samantalang yung liability component, fair value, at the end of each year. Kaya, gagamitin natin itong mga balance na ito. So, in this case, ginamit natin ito, yung fair value ng liability on January 1 for the purpose of getting the fair value of the equity component, residual approach, kung ano yung matira after your liability computation. Okay? Please take note. Parang nagulo ko yata kayo. Sir, ano? Paulit nga. Anyway, sige. Please take note of this related journal entries. Uulitin ko lang ha, on January 1, 2021, memorandum entry tayo dyan kasi same lang naman yan ng cash settled or equity settled. Pero paano on December 31? Tignan ninyo ito, no? Debit ka ng compensation expense, credit ka ng SARs payable, credit ka ng share premium, share option. Saan galing tong mga to? Ano yung exercise, ano yung vesting period dito? 2 years, no? May service condition tayo dito na 2 years. So, 2 years ang vesting period natin. Now, take note of this. Ang equivalent shares for cash payment para sa computation ng fair value ng liability, ha? 4,000, di ba? Multiplied by the fair value at December 31, 2021 na 68. So, 272. Or pick up mo ito. Okay? Proportion of years completed over vesting period, 1 over 2. Divide mo yan ng 2. Ang compensation expense mo attributable to the liability component ay etong 136,000. Compensation expense mo yan, part yan nitong 156. Pero credit ka ng share appreciation rights payable of 136,000. As to the equity component, dahil we are using the fair value at the date of grant, eto yon divided by 2. You know, 40,000 divided by 2. 20, kaya 136 for the liability, 20 for the equity, ang compensation expense mo ay 156. Okay? So, that's it, no? Pagdating ng 2022 na bago yung fair value, gagamitin natin ito. So, may recomputation na naman tayo for the fair value of the liability. 4,000 times, ito na, 72, 288. Oh, proportion is 2 over 2. Eh di, ito na mismo yung cumulative na compensation expense. Eh meron ka nang na-expense ng 2021 na 136. So, for 2022, compensation expense related to the liability component ay 152,000. And then, syempre, 40,000 divided by 2. Diba? 20,000 pa rin. Kaya, ang compensation expense natin ng 2022 ay 172,000. Okay? So, yan, ano, class? That is your journal entry for 2022. Now, ano itong, ano, June 30, 2023. Tignan ninyo ito. Anong sinasabi dito? To record change in fair value in the debt component. Kasi nga, yung component natin, di ba, for the financial, for the liability, SARS payable, di ba, yung liability dito sa share appreciation rights, ina-update natin hanggat hindi pa nasisettle. So, ganun din dito, no? Meron kang change, no? Nung June 30, 2023, from 72 naging 75. Okay? So, dito, no? We will have to debit 12,000, credit 12,000 for the share appreciation rights payable. Or simply, that is your 300,000 minus 288,000. O, eto yung 288,000 mo. Okay? Saan galing itong 300,000? O, 300,000 comes from 4,000 times 75. Yan po ba yun? O, kindly do the double checking. 4,000 times 75. That is your 300,000. Hindi ko na yata na isama dito sa ating computation. Pero yun po yun. Ano? Okay, please take note. The balance of the debt is the fair value at the date of settlement. The balance of the equity is the fair value at the date of grant. That is the difference between the liability section and then the equity section. So now, pagdating sa dulo ng taon, June 30, 2023, may dalawang option si COO, no? Si COO ba ito? Tama ba ako? Oo, si COO, si officer, no? Avail ko ba yung share appreciation rights or avail ko yung share premium? Or I mean, cash or equity component? If the officer chooses the cash settlement, ito yung recording. Siyempre, de-debit mo yung SARS payable na 300,000. I-debit mo yung share premium share options. Saan galing yan? O syempre, yung equity section. Okay? I-credit mo yung cash. Ito yung ano eh. Naka-basis tayo, on the basis of the 75, di ba? Times 4,000. Okay? So, yan yung babayad ni entity kay COO. O, share premium from unexercised share options will be credited. Kasi hindi natin in-exercise to. Diba? So, reclassify from one equity to another equity component. Pero, If the officer opted for the equity instrument, oh, ganito naman yung ating journal entry. Definitely, same ka ng debit. Tatanggalin mo yan eh. Na liability and then the equity component. Pero ang credit mo dito instead of cash, it will be ordinary share capital. Pero syempre, at the par value. And the par value here is 40 pesos. Ayun, ano given dito? Par value is 40. So, 200,000 lang yung credit natin sa ordinary share capital. The difference will be credited from share premium, no? Share premium, sandali. Bakit share premium from unexercised share options? Share premium ordinary. Oh, namali na naman tayo, no? Buti na lang napapansin. Share premium ordinary share. Inexercise na kasi ito. No? Nagkakamali lang tayo, no? Or kapag kinapi natin from the previous journal entries. Ayan, share premium ordinary. O, yan dapat yung ating journal entry. Okay? Or ordinary share. O, tama naman yun eh. Ayan, ordinary share. So, there you go, no? That is our journal entry. Now, please take note, isang tao lang ito. Pag multiple employees ang pinag-uusapan natin, kailangan natin i-consider ilang employees yon at kada isang employee, ilan yung options na i-grant. Okay? So, ayan, ano? This is the last stretch, last hurrah for our IFRS 2 on share-based payments. So, I hope you learned something, no, from this video lecture. So, hanggang dito na po ang ating ano, video lecture. Salamat sa susunod ulit for another set of topics. I'll see you around. Thank you. Bye-bye.